Hello dear student, today in this video we will learn how to draw the cam profile for the follower motion as a uniform velocity. Now to draw the cam profile we take a numerical problem, and the numerical problem is that this is the cam motion, cam movement, which is given as follow, that is outer stroke during the 60 degree of the cam rotation. That means when the cam is rotated at 60 degree, during this 60 degree rotation of the cam, then there is a outward outer stroke, and dual for the next 30 degree of the cam rotation, return stroke during the next 60 degree of the cam rotation, and dual for the remaining 210 degree of the cam rotation. In this numerical problem, you can see here the stroke of the follower is 40 mm and minimum radius of cam is 50 mm. The follower moves with the uniform velocity during the both outer stroke and return stroke. Now draw the cam profile for the cam. Now these are two conditions. First is that we have to draw the cam profile. In this case, that is, we can see here, that is A, the axis of the cam follower passes through the axis of the cam shaft, and the second case is the axis of the follower is offset by 20 mm from the axis of the shaft. Now let us start with the first case, that is the when the cam axis and follower axis are collinear, and the given problem is here that the stroke of the follower is 40 mm. We have to take a pen from here. This is the stroke and this is the minimum radius of cam, and these are the conditions, these are the cases for which we have to draw the cam profile, and this is the condition for the knife edge follower. Now in this slide we can see here, this is a displacement diagram. Now we will discuss how to draw the displacement diagram for these cases. First of all, we have to take a suitable scale, and in this diagram we use 10 degree is equal to 1 cm. Now 60 degree is equal to 6 cm, and 30 degree is equal to 3 cm. After that 360 degree is equal to 6 cm, and remaining 210 is equal to something degree, which is we explained here. You can see this line. Now first of all, draw a straight line as a AX. We can see here A and X, this is the straight line, and measure the A in the vertical direction up to Y, that is equal to 40 mm. We can see here this is a 40 mm, and draw the 40 mm from the A point to the Y, and after that draw a parallel line to the AX as Y. We can see here this is the parallel line up to this point as a AX. Now this 60 degree is further divided into 6 equal number of parts, that is 1 part, 2 part, 3, 4, 6, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this is the divided 60 degree is divided into 6 equal number of parts. Similarly, during the return stroke, we have to also divide the 60 degree into 6 equal number of parts. We can also divide 4 equal number of parts, 8 equal number of parts, 12 number of equal parts, depending upon the availability of the size. And one advantage is there that if you take the, if you divide the strokes as a maximum, then our the profile of the cam becomes very smooth. And we have to draw, we have to, in this problem we take 6 part, and there is no any division in the dual period, that is 30 degree and remaining of the 210 degrees, there is no any division, and this is a stroke. After divided into 6 equal number of part for the outer stroke and return stroke, draw a straight diagonally line from A to G and G to H. After that H to P. We can see here that is pink in color. We can also draw This is H to P. Now, name the all point that cut at the division point. That is, this one number of line is cut at this point. This is called the B, and this zero is at the A. Similarly, number two line cut at this point C, and three can be cut at the point D, and similarly we can see here six is cut at the G. Similarly, in the return stroke, zero at H, sorry, zero dash at the H, one dash J, two dash K, three dash L, four dash M, five dash N, and six dash P. This is lies in the same point. Now, this is the displacement diagram for the uniform velocity conditions. Now, next step is to draw the cam profile. In this diagram, we can see here this is the cam profile, and let us learn how to draw the cam profile. First of all, we have to draw a circle which is equal to 50 mm as a radius. You can see here, because in this problem, this is given as the minimum cam radius is a 50 mm. Now I have to draw the 50 mm radius as a circle. We can see here, this is a circle whose radius is 50 mm as given in the numerical problem. And the first case is that when the axis of the follower passes through the axis of the camshaft. Now, the profile of the cam when the axis of the follower passes through the axis of the camshaft is drawn, which is discussed in this diagram. Now we can see here, this is the follower, this is knife edge follower. You can see here, this is the knife edge follower. And in this knife edge follower, the line of action of the knife edge follower is passes through the center of the cam. The C my pen passes through the cam, that is O as a center. Now in this diagram, we have to divide from this is a reference line, and we have to draw make a 60 degree angle for the outer stroke. You can see here, this is a 60 degree, and after that 30 degree for the dual condition, and further this is 60 degree for the return stroke, and remaining this is the 210 degrees. The next step is to divide the outer stroke angles, that is 60 degree, into six equal number of parts, as we can see in the displacement diagram. Because if the displacement diagram is divided in eight number of parts, then we have to also divide the 60 degree into eight equal number of parts. But in this displacement diagram, we already divide the outer stroke into six number of equal parts. That's why in this profile, we have to also divide the 60 degree into six equal number of part. Now, so this is here, this 60 degree is divided into six equal number of part. That is 10 degree, 10 degree, 10 degree, 10 degree, 10 degree, and this is 10 degree. 10 to 6 is equal to 60 degree, and this line can be extended from center of the cam. You can see here, this can be also extended. This can be also extended as per the requirement availability of the pitch. Similarly, we have to also divide the six equal number apart for the return stroke. Now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. As we divide this line into six equal number of parts, similarly here we have to also divide it into six number of equal parts, that is the 10 degree. And there is no any division in the dual condition, that is in 30 degree and 210 degrees. Now the next step is to measure the displacement from the displacement diagram. Take a compass and measure the distance from one. You can see here, this is the one and B. Now put the compass at the point one, because this is the one division, zero at A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because this is divided into six equal number of part. So put the compass at the point B and cut the point, whatever the distance measured from the displacement diagram, at this point, cut this point as here. Now further then measure the point distance from 2 to C and put a compass at the point 2 and cut the point from pencil here. Similarly, measure the all distance up to 6, that is 3 to D, 4 to E, 5 to F and 6 to G, and cut the all points from the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 at the circumference of the base circle of the camp. We can see here that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and cut the all distances. Similarly, during the return stroke, we have to also measure the distance from the compass. We take the distance 0 dash to H. Now in this case, first is 0 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash and 6 dash. Now measure the distance 0 dash to H, put a compass here and cut the point. This will be also extended. You can extend the all lines if required like this. Now put the compass at 2 dash, measure the 1 dash at G. Now 1 dash at G, 2 dash at K, similarly the 6 dash at B. All point can be cut like this. Now the next step is to join the all points in a curve. Now you can see from the A, join the first point B, C, D, E, F, G and make a smooth curve here for the dual condition, and H, J, K, K is here, L, M, N and P. Now this will be the cam profile for this special condition for the cam rotation. We can see further in this diagram, this is the cam profile. This is the cam profile for this condition. This is the cam profile. Now the and in this one thing is here that if the displacement diagram is clear and all the points is curve is, the distance from the center is totally depends upon the accuracy of the displacement diagram. Now the second case is that when the axis of the follower is offset by 20 mm from the axis of the camshaft. This type of this is also called a type of follower, and in this offset condition the axis of the follower is not passes through the center of the cam, and in this condition this is distance is given as a 20 mm. For this condition displacement diagram will same for the both cases, and we can there is no need to draw the further displacement diagram. We can draw only the cam profile for this condition. Now this is the displacement diagram. Now let's start how to draw the cam profile for this condition. तो सबसे पहले इसमें हम क्या करेंगे कि 50 mm radius मान के एक base circle draw कर लेंगे, जो कि यहाँ पे हम देख पा रहे हैं. इसके बाद center से जितना offset डिस्टेंस दिया हुआ है वो ऑफसेट का डिस्टेंस को रेडियस मान के एक छोटा सर्कल हम इसी सेम सेंटर पे ड्रॉ कर लेंगे, एंड एक्सिस को हम सेंटर से 20 एमएम डिस्टेंस पे नाइफ एज फॉलोअर को रख दिए. आप देख पाते हैं यहाँ पे दिस इज कॉल्ड नाइफ एज फॉलोअर. नाउ दिस एक्सिस ऑफ द फॉलोअर इज पासेस थ्रू दिस पॉइंट एंड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दिस एक्सिस फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द कैम इज 20 mm, you can see here, and this circle is called the offset circle, and this 50 mm as a radius circle is called the base circle of the cam profile. Now as the process in the previous cases, let us start in these cases. For these cases, firstly we have to also divide the 60 degree first from the this point from the center and make this degree as a make an angle to 60 degree. We can see here this is 60 degree, and after that this is 30 degree. We can see here, and after that this is 60 degree for the return stroke. As we are already draw in the previous cases. Now the second case is that divide the 60 degree. we can say here this 60 degree into 6 number of equal parts, and we assume that the degree is taken from this circumference, this tangential point at this at the offset circle. हम यहां से एंगल को बनाएंगे और कुछ 6 इक्वल पार्ट में डिवाइड कर लिए. दिस इज 1 2 3 4 5 एंड दिस इज 6. स्टार्ट करते हैं यहां से हम, तो सब जो जितना भी इसमें जो डिवीजन किया गया है एंगल का वो 10 10 डिग्री का है, एंड 10 इज इक्वल टू 6 इज इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री, बिकॉज़ ये जो आउट स्ट्रोक एंगल हमारा कैम का है वो 60 डिग्री है. हम इस लाइन को बढ़ा भी सकते हैं आगे एज पर द अवेलेबिलिटी एंड रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द drawing, we can extend this line. Similarly, we can also divide this angle during the return stroke, and at the last point of the during the outer stroke, we can start a tangent. We can draw the tangent from here and divide this is into 6 part, that is 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. छह पार्ट में इसको भी डिवाइड कर देंगे हम. सिमिलरली जो हम आगे एक्सटेंड इसको भी कर सकते हैं एक्सटेंड, अगर रिक्वायरमेंट है तो, नहीं तो छोड़ देंगे हम जैसे है. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज सिमिलर, दैट इज मेजर द डिस्टेंस विद द हेल्प ऑफ कंपास. 0A एक पॉइंट, बिकॉज वी नीड ए पॉइंट टू ड्रॉ द कैम प्रोफाइल. हमको कैम प्रोफाइल ड्रॉ करने के लिए हमें पॉइंट चाहिए, तो पॉइंट पुट करने के लिए डिस्प्लेसमेंट डायग्राम का हम लोग हेल्प लेते हैं, और डिस्प्लेसमेंट डायग्राम से ही डिस्टेंस को हम लोग मेजर करके यहाँ पे हम लोग पॉइंट को पाते हैं. जैसे कि 0A, तो ये एक पॉइंट हो गया हमारा. दूसरा में है 1B, तो यहाँ से 1 एज B, 1 पे कंपास को रखे पेंसिल से B को कट कर देंगे. सिमिलियरली 2C, 2 को पे कंपास को रखें C को कट कर लिए हम. 3D यहाँ पे कट कर लेंगे हम. 4E यहाँ पे कट कर लेंगे. 5F एंड 6G, तो यहाँ पे 6 पॉइंट हमें मिल गए, एंड अलोंग विद 0 दैट इज 7 पॉइंट, दैट इज 1 2 3 4 5 6 एंड 7. सिमिलियरली रिटर्न स्ट्रोक के ड्यूरेशन में भी हम मेजर कर लेंगे यहाँ से. ड्यूरिंग द रिटर्न स्ट्रोक, दैट इज द डिस्टेंस टेकन फ्रॉम द हेल्प ऑफ कंपास, दैट इज 0-H. वी कैन पुट द कंपास हियर एंड कट दिस लाइन एट द पॉइंट H. 1 to J, 1 point is here. 2-K, 3-L, 4-M, 5-N and 6-P, which is lies in the same point. Now also we have 7 point. 1 2 3 4 5 6, and this is 7 along with the P. Now total we have 14 points. Now from the in as a previous cases, we have to meet the all points together like this. We can see here, and here we have to make a smooth curve for the dual condition, and also meet the all point during the return stroke and draw a smooth curve at the point P6-. Now this is the cam profile for this offset condition. We can easily understand from this diagram that follower is here and this is offset, this is the cam, and if you cut get the point, that is the 4 5 6 7. Similarly in the return stroke, 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7, and meet the all point together, make a smooth curve, that is called the cam profile for this given condition. If you take the many numbers in the displacement diagram, if you take the 8 number, then we will get the 10 point here, and as the number of points get increasing, the quality of curve get very smooth and the quality of cam profile becomes very better than the less number of division. If you divide the 4 equal number of parts in the displacement diagram, that the curve is not looking good and curve is not in a smooth. So as the division of the, in the displacement diagram getting increasing, now the curve, or we can say the profile of the cam get very smooth. Thank you.